In this video, we're going to look at how we use screen sharing on the iPad with iPadOS 18. In addition to screen sharing, Apple also added the ability to draw on someone else's iPad screen when you're sharing it, and you can even control their iPad screen. Let's see how this works. Now, before we get started, if you like what you see here, stick around to the end. I'll tell you a little bit more about myself and how you can help support my efforts in creating these videos. All right, let's take a look at the new iPad sharing screen options we have with iPadOS 18. Let's go over to my iPad. I should say, let's go over to my iPads. So I have two iPads here. This is my demo iPad. This is the one that I normally do my recordings with. It's an iPad 11-inch, iPad Pro 11-inch, and it is running iPadOS 18. This iPad here is also an iPad Pro. It's a 13-inch, and it is running iPadOS 18 as well. So this is a requirement. Both iPads need to be running iPadOS 18 in order for you to control the screen. In other words, what I'm going to do is I'm going to go from this iPad here, and I'm going to ask this person here if I can see their screen, and then I'm also going to control it, new in iPadOS 18. So both of them have to be using iPadOS 18. I can also do the opposite. What I'm able to do is I'm able to share this screen with that person as well. And if this person makes a call over here, they are able to control that iPad, or what they're able to do is share the screen. So now how does this all work? Well, basically there's two different ways to do this. We can do this through the Messages app, or we can do this through FaceTime. It actually all works through FaceTime. But I'm gonna show you how this works with the Messages app first, because there's a little trick when you use the Messages app. When you use the Messages app, what you're able to do is see if the other person is using iPadOS 18. Again, that's a requirement if you wanna use all of these new features. Both devices need to have iPadOS 18 or later. So what I wanna do is I want to message, or I'm gonna start a message with this person here. But instead of sending a message, I'm going to ask him if I can see their screen. So the way that we do that is we just go and open up the Messages app. So I'm going to tap on Messages here. And then we go over to our conversation. So this is the conversation that I want. Now, instead of typing out a message, what we need to do is we just need to go up to the little video icon here in the upper right-hand corner. Now, this is nothing new, but what is new, if both devices are using iPadOS 18, what you're going to see is the option to share the screen or ask to share the screen. So this is that little trick. If you do not see this, if you're trying to control someone's screen and you do not see this, that means that that other person is not using iPadOS 18. So go and ask them to upgrade to iPadOS 18. Once they do that, and you are running iPadOS 18, then you're going to see these options. That's why I like to use this message or this method of controlling the screen, because I can easily see if they need to upgrade or not. Okay, so both of these are running iPadOS 18. Let's go and see how this all works. What I'm going to do is I'm going to ask to share this screen here over there. So what I have to do is I just have to tap on ask to share screen. I'm going to ask them to share their screen. And it's going to make a call to them. So let's go ahead and do that. I tap on it. And now we can see it's making a call. And then the other iPad, there it is. So I tap on accept down here. And it's going to accept that call. And up at the top here, we have share. So all I have to do is just say allow this to share. So I'm going to tap on share here. And when I do, you're going to see over on the other iPad here, it's sharing that screen. So what I'm going to do on the iPad that I'm sharing, I'm going to swipe up from the bottom to get to the home screen. So this is another little trick. When you do this, ask the person to just go to their home screen. So watch what happens when I swipe up. Now we can see on this other iPad that home screen. So when I go and move to a different home screen, I'm just going to swipe over to the right over here. And you're going to see it moved it over here. Now, right now, it is just a small window. But when we tap on that, what it's going to do is it's going to fill up the other iPad. So let's go ahead and tap on it. It does put it into a little bit of a windowed mode because we do have some other controls up here. More on that in a little bit. But basically, what I'm able to do now is as I move around this iPad here, we can see that it is showing it on the other iPad. So that person is now sharing their screen with this person. Now, that's nice, but with iPadOS 18, we can also draw on that screen. So let's say I wanted to highlight this app here. How can I do that? Well, basically, all I have to do is just go and draw on this screen here. When I do that, what it'll do is it'll draw it on that screen as well. So it makes it really easy to highlight. Now, it's going to be a little bit of a light red, and I have to simulate the draw here. My screen recording software doesn't record that part of it, but you'll see what I mean as soon as I do it. So I'm going to draw a red circle around here, and then you're going to see, or I'm going to mimic it over here. So let's go ahead and do that. So I draw maps, or play, I'm sorry. I'm going to draw around play here, and that's what it'll do. If I were to draw an arrow, I just go and draw an arrow here, and it'll draw an arrow over there, just like that. So we can easily point something out when we use that little annotate feature. In addition to that, we can also control their screen. So how do we do that? Let's say I wanted to control the screen here. Well, basically, all we have to do is just tap on the little control icon here in the upper left-hand corner. I'm going to control it from this iPad here. So now I tap on that. Now I'm able to control that screen. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to swipe over to the left here. And what's going to happen is this screen here will also go to the left. I'm controlling their screen. So I swipe, and it goes there. So if I were to open up an app, let's go ahead and open up Unsplash here. What it's going to do is open up Unsplash on that other iPad. I'm going to go back to the home screen. I swipe up, and we're back at the home screen. And now it shows the home screen on the other iPad. And I swipe to the left, and it goes back over to the left. So in addition to drawing on the screen, I can also control their screen. When you are done controlling it, all you have to do is just tap on this again, and it will go in. So that's how we can control the screen. When you are done, all you have to do is just stop the call. So I'm going to get out of control here, and it's stopping the control. And now what I do is I just tap on the little green button here to get to my FaceTime controls. Again, it's all done through FaceTime, and I tap on stop. So I stop it, and now it is no longer controlling that screen. So that's how we can do this through the Messages app. And again, that's my favorite way of doing it because of this little trick right down here. What we're able to do is see if that other person is using iPadOS 18. But we can also do this from FaceTime. So let's say you're on a FaceTime call, and what you would like to do is control the screen. Maybe you want to show them something. Well, all you have to do is just go and start a FaceTime call with them. So I'm going to go over to FaceTime here. We're going to basically do the same thing, but this time we're going to use the FaceTime app. And I go and call the person. And now I go and answer it over here. And when I do, I'm going to have the option to control their screen. So how do you do that? Well, basically what we need to do is we need to go to this little icon here. And when I do, you're going to see I have the option to share the screen or control their screen. Or share my screen or ask to share their screen. Sorry. Once you share the screen, then you can control it. So do you want to share your screen or do you want to ask them to share their screen? Once you do that, it works basically the same way as it did through the Messages app. You're able to control it as well as draw on it. When you are done, being that this is FaceTime, all you have to do is just go and tap on the red X, and it'll end that FaceTime call. And now we're back to our two separate iPads. So that's how you can share the screen and even control it with iPadOS 18. And just so you know, it also works on iOS 18 with the iPhone. The key to making this whole thing work is you do need to have iPadOS 18 on both devices. That's why I like to use the Messages app trick to make sure that the other person does have iPadOS 18. Otherwise, you're not going to be able to control their screen. But this is a great way to offer support for friends and family. If you wanted to do that, you can just do this through FaceTime or through the Messages app. Just make sure that they have iPadOS 18 on their device. So that's how you can now screen share the different options we have with screen sharing on iPadOS 18. Now, if you found this video helpful, what you may want to do is like the video, subscribe to my channel, or even share it with friends and family. In addition to that, you may want to check out danstutorials.com. I do have over 400 videos on YouTube, but I have a lot more on my site. I've been doing this a lot longer on my site, danstutorials.com. So how can you help support my efforts? Well, the site is a membership-based site. You can view the videos for free on the site, but they do include ads. When you become a member of my site, I take out all of the ads of the videos. You also get access to an AI assistant modeled after an Apple Genius. And you get access to my classes and webinars, which I hold on a regular basis. And then also, you are helping support a small company. It is just me in a corner office in my house. I'm not part of some large organization. So when you become a member of my site, you are directly supporting my efforts in creating these videos. Check out dancetutorials.com for more information, and thanks for watching.